We'll be right back. time with the gramophone. It's not so. Today, a composer who writes for the cinema reaches a worldwide audience to begin with. And it is the only form of art today which uses music as part of its artistic expression. I don't feel, though, that the theater, for example, the living theater, uses music to the extent that the cinema does. As a matter of fact, I may be bold enough to say that, with very few exceptions, a piece of film or a film cannot come to life without the help of music of some kind. Hitchcock, who deals very rarely with character portrayal, or has little or no interest in people's emotions, but who deals in situations generally that of a suspenseful nature. His interest in music is only in relationship to how the suspense can be heightened. Or while Orson Welles, who the films I did with him, three, Kane, The Magnificent Ambersons, Journey to the Theater, all these three films dealt with characters, with people's emotions and attitudes, and therefore the music for such films of a entirely different nature. In Hitchcock, one has to create a landscape for each film, whether it be the rainy night of Psycho or the turbulence of a picture such as Vertigo, as against the Citizen Kane, a picture of people within a specific time and how they felt against external events. You have attitudes of hatred, love, revenge. Film music must supply what actors cannot say. The music can give to an audience their feelings. It must really convey what the words cannot do. If you're dealing with an emotional subject, this is the complete purpose of a film score. But if you're dealing with a picture such as, well, a Hitchcock film or anyone's film, or by anyone of enormous skill and taste in the making of the film, as a film is only made of segments of film that are put together and either artificially linked by dissolves or cuts or montages, and many ways in which a film can be made. It is the function of music to cement these pieces into one design that the audience feels that their sequence is inevitable. Now, it is one of the paradoxes of cinema music that music correctly used can be music of very poor quality and be effective, or can be music of magnificent quality and also serve its purpose. But the strange thing about cinema, and this would go for television film, is that no one really knows why music is needed. I would say after a lifetime in it, I cannot tell you why, but it is not complete without it. Rights in it, people do write the paper saying you shouldn't have music in your television, it's all too, the noise is too loud and all this is rubbish. All you have to do would be to look at a film without music and it would be almost unbearable to look at it. And I feel that it is a responsibility of any gifted composer of our time to do a certain amount of creative work in these media. I believe that all composers at all times had to do music of their time and meet the music that was needed. I mean, after all, Mozart and Haydn were not above writing dinner music while their patrons ate, and they were not above writing music for special singers or instrumentalists. And on the other hand, Bach certainly thought nothing of writing his weekly cantata for a church service. It's only a question of the time one lives in. The present time we live in is cinema and television. Contemporary music, and by contemporary music I mean that you can have experimentation in both those mediums, in the most avant-garde musical techniques, and an audience will accept it providing it is compatible with the dramatic situation of the film.
sincere and dedicated smile, like a calm veteran of the psychic war. He was no general, for he was not old. He was no private, for he could not be sold. He was only a man, and his dedication extended to the last degree. Poor pretentious soldier, come home. The dark Los Angeles evening is steaming the church that we attended, and I miss my boy. Stupid and green, what the color green? When I watch the TV and I see helicopters swirling their brutal and bountiful sensation over the fields and the comic walls, I can only smile and fix a meal and think about the child who will one day own. In conclusion, darling, let me repeat, your home.
Boiler Room, put your hands together for Carl Craig.
Thank you very much. I'm glad that you came out tonight. Thank you. Thanks to Francesco Tristano. Thanks to everyone. I love you.